fellow intellectuals. I'm Dr. Albert, and I have a little pop quiz question for you today. What are the three main adverse effects of insulin therapy? The three main adverse effects are hypoglycemia, lipodystrophy, and weight gain. The good news is, your patient's behind could have its own gravitational pull. I cracked myself up. Good day, class. Today we will be talking about gastric cancer. More importantly, its aggressiveness. Gastric cancer is known for metastasizing to other areas of the body. Who can tell me the most commonly tested locations for gastric cancer spread? Firkos node. This is a lymph node full of metastatic cancer cells in the left supraclavicular fossa at the base of the neck. Firko was German, you know. Sister Mary Joseph's nodule. This is a lymph node full of metastatic cells found next to the umbilicus. It can be associated with any gastrointestinal malignancies or sometimes gynecological cancers. And Krukenberg's tumor. This is a metastatic tumor to the ovary, often from GI or breast origin. What do you know? Krukenberg was German too. That reminds me of a little joke from the old country. Two Germans and a nun walk into a bar. It was a German, an Irishman, and a priest. Two Irishmen and a priest and... Wait. A priest, a rabbi, and a theoretical astrophysicist walk into a bar. Hello, Dr. Einstein here again. Feel like you're absorbing all the information? We shall see about that. Tell me this. Is conjugation a phase one or phase two reaction? Need some time, do we? Very good. The answer is phase two. Conjugation usually leaves the drug inactive. If you thought that was too easy, then here's a real doozy for you. Which takes place first, phase one metabolism or phase two? Trick question. The reactions can take place in any order. You just got Stein, son. Hello there. Are you ready for another question? If you have a patient with calcium kidney stones, what kind of diuretic should you avoid? Loop diuretic. Remember, loops lose calcium, so your patient may have more frequent stones if you increase renal calcium excretion. A thiazide diuretic, however, might actually help prevent stones since thiazides reduce renal excretion. All this talk about renal excretion has my nephrons working overtime. Please excuse while I take a little pinkle pause. When did I get the bladder of a two-year-old? Hello! Enjoying your studying so far? Ready for today's pop quiz? What is a diagnostic exam used in a patient with sudden focal neurologic deficit? Got it? The answer is CT of the head without contrast. And why is it necessary to have the patient undergo CT without contrast first? The first thing to rule out is a hemorrhagic stroke, which is ruled out with a CT without contrast. So, a brain walks into a bar and orders a beer. And the bartender says, "Sorry, sir, I can't serve you. You're already out of your head." Login, students! Which class of HIV drugs causes redistribution of fat into a buffalo hump on the back of the neck? Protease inhibitors such as saquinavir or ritonavir. Oh, I get it now. My humps, my lovely lady lumps. Hello, students. Who's jazzed to be discussing biostatistics today? Oh well, I will just have to be excited enough for all of us. Now, today's topic is the evaluation of diagnostic tests. How do you determine sensitivity and specificity? Sensitivity is the proportion of all the people with the disease who test positive. Expressed mathematically, sensitivity is equal to true positives divided by everyone with the disease, which is true positives plus false negatives. And specificity is the proportion of all the people without the disease who test negative. Or specificity equals true negatives divided by everyone without the disease, or true negatives plus false positives. Whew! And I thought E equals MC squared was a mouthful. Pretty clever, huh? Yeah, well, I didn't win the Nobel Prize for nothing, you know. Hello? Are you feeling the mental burn yet? Ready to test your knowledge noggin? What is the enzyme that converts glucose to sorbitol? Do you have it yet? Aldose reductase. And which tissues lack sorbitol dehydrogenase, the enzyme that converts sorbitol to fructose? I'm waiting. The kidneys, the lens and retina of the eye, and Schwann cells. Who doesn't just love a girl in a tutu? Guten Tag, my little doctors to be. Are your studies going well? Yeah? Good. Today's question is about croup, which is characterized by barking cough, stridor, hoarseness, and difficulty breathing. So, what is the name of the radiographic sign associated with croup that is seen on AP X-ray of the neck? Need a hint? Yeah, you got it. Stiepel sign. On X-ray, you see a narrowing of the trachea, which produces an inverted V, known as Stiepel sign. So, when you see Stiepel sign, think croup. Stiepel sign, croup. See, there it is, croup. Croup, there it is, croup, there it is, croup, there it is, oh, croup, there it is. Sing it with me, croup. Season's greetings, my friends. I'm sure you're wondering why on earth I'm dressed in this crazy thing, right? Well, I want to talk about pityriasis rosea. First, don't confuse pityriasis rosea with rosacea. Rosacea is characterized by facial erythema and flushing, telangiectasias, and inflammatory papules, and is usually seen in middle age. And don't confuse pityriasis rosea with pityriasis versicolor, which is just another name for tinea versicolor, a dermatophyte infection. Pityriasis rosea is characterized by a scaly pink oval lesion called a Herold patch. Then you get numerous oval patches across the trunk, spreading out like the branches of a Christmas tree. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. Achoo! Gesundheit! Spring is in the air, which means I have the hay fever. I have mastered the mysteries of the cosmos, but I cannot seem to master my allergies. Ugh, mein Lieber, this hay fever will be the end of me. This is worse than the time I caught the disco fever. At least with that I got to wear platform shoes.